I seek unanimous consent to enter into the record a December 30th, 2005 essay written by Mr. John Dean entitled George W. Bush as the New Richard Nixon, both wiretapped illegally and impeachably.
Without objection.
Mr. Dean, how many American presidents have you accused of being Richard Nixon?
I actually wrote a book about Mr. Bush and Mr. Cheney with the title Worse Than Watergate.
So it's sort of become a cottage. Did you make money on that book?
It was a very successful book,
yes. How much money did you make on it?
I'm sorry, I don't have any idea.
More than $1 million?
No.
More than $500,000?
I said I don't have any idea.
How much money do you make from CNN?
I don't really know exactly.
I think I'm going to object to the...
Wait a second. Mr. Dean has made a cottage industry out of accusing presidents of acting like Richard Nixon. I would like to know how much money he makes based on making these accusations and exploiting them for his own economic benefit.
Mr. Gates, it's not by choice that I've done a lot of this. It's that I've been dragged into it.
Who forced you to accuse George W. Bush of being Richard Nixon?
Who forced me to? It was right after I had spent 10 years in a lawsuit knocking down false statements about what my role had and hadn't been.
Well, let's speak now to the truth or falsity of statements. Do you have personal knowledge regarding the truth or falsity of a single material fact in the Mueller report?
I think if you recall the first thing I said, I'm not here as a fact witness.
You're here to provide historical context.
Exactly.
And throughout history, you accuse presidents of acting like Richard Nixon and you make money off of it, right?
Not all presidents, no.
Well, but a few more
than
one.
Those who do act like him, I point it out.
Let me ask you this question. How do Democrats plan to pay for Medicare for all?
I'm sorry?
I figured if we were going to ask you about stuff you don't know about, we'd start with the big stuff. So do you know how they plan to pay for Medicare for all?
Who? The Democrats? Or which candidate? Or can you be more specific?
Let's get specific to Nixon, since that appears to be why you're here. If we turned the lights off here and maybe lit some candles, got out a Ouija board, we could potentially raise the specter of Richard Nixon.
I doubt that.
Well, it seems to be the objective. You know, here we sit today in this hearing with the ghost of Christmas past because the chairman of the committee has gone to the Speaker of the House and sought permission to open an impeachment inquiry. But she has said no. And so instead of opening the impeachment inquiry into Donald Trump, which is what the chairman wants to do and what I presume a majority of Democrats want to do, we're here reopening the impeachment inquiry potentially into Richard Nixon, sort of playing out our own version of that 70s show. And what I really regret...
It is striking, Mr. Gates. You're here as a prop.
You are functionally here as a prop because they can't impeach President Trump because 70% of Democrats want something that 60% of Americans don't. So they're in this no-win situation, and you sit before us here with no knowledge of a single fact on the Mueller report, on a hearing entitled Lessons from the Mueller Report.
Mr. Gates, can I answer your question, please?
It's not your time, Mr. Dean. It's my time. So here's the deal, right? We have a false accusation against the President of the United States that he was an agent of Russia. My colleagues on the Democratic side made that accusation. And so where do we go from here? Either we look into how the President reacted to a false allegation against him, or we look into why for 22 months, we allowed a false accusation to tear this country apart. Now, to me, it seems like a far more relevant inquiry to figure out why the FISA court was lied to, something that you have spoken a great deal about, Mr. Dean, to find out why the recordings and the transcripts from George Papadopoulos, where he asserted that he wasn't doing any work with Russia, was not brought before the FISA court. None of that. We also would love to know why the FBI turned from an organization that was supposed to be investigating crimes into one that sought to shape public opinion. You had Comey and McCabe and that whole regime of leadership lying and leaking. And the reason they were doing it is because they didn't really think that the job of the FBI was to investigate and bring cases for prosecution. They thought the role of the FBI was to try to shape public opinion. And that's really why we're here. And that's what I really think all Americans ought to have an interest in stopping. And you held these views. You wrote them down. You said that illegal surveillance was one of the worst things that we should fight against as a government. And now here we are continuing to engage in this frivolous exercise of going after the president, despite the fact that there was absolutely no collusion. You guys need to get your act together and figure out if you're going to open an impeachment inquiry or not, because this is a straight-up fiction. I yield back.